What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. So today we are going to be covering the Bell Gargoyles boss fight. Now I'm going to do a live commentary today as opposed to what I was doing with my other guides. Just see how it goes. I'm hoping to get a bit more like in-depth commentary into the boss fight, be able to bait out some more attacks and analyze it as we go. Also, this way will make it a lot easier for me to edit so I can get these videos out faster. If you liked the old way better though, just let me know in the comments and we will do that in the future. But to start things off, I will be showing you a couple of things to do to prep for the boss fight, and then we'll get right into it. So first things first, I do recommend actually starting from Firelink Shrine rather than Undead Parish, even though that's where the gargoyles are, because as you can see right now I have 5 Estus, rest of that bonfire, now we have 10. I also recommend using a humanity in becoming human, as there are some very helpful summons for this boss fight. And with that, we can just head up to the church. Now, there are 2 summons you can get for this boss fight. One of them, very straightforward, it's Solaire, the guy you met right after Taurus Demon. All you had to do is talk to him there and he will be available for this boss fight. The other one is a bit more complicated, it is Lautrec. If you watched my other videos, you might know who he is. And by the way, I'm not wearing a shirt just by choice. If I put on more armor, I'll not be able to roll very well. I just thought I'd put that out there. Anyways, Lautrec, we do have to free him from a cage up ahead here. And if we do that though, do a series of steps, we will be able to summon him. So first things first, if you haven't already, I do recommend going down that way and upgrading your weapon at the blacksmith. To do so, you're going to need some Titanite shards, all these Balder Knights that you can see in that room there. There are quite a few. There's one on the bridge over there. There's one just up these stairs here. They all have a pretty good drop rate for Titanite shards. If you don't really want to farm them, you can buy them for 800 souls apiece from the blacksmith, and actually reinforcing your weapon only costs like a couple hundred souls, 200 to 300 maybe. So you can get that all the way up to +5 if you sit here and grind those out long enough. I am working with a +1 claymore right now, not the best, but it should do just fine. Now, as for getting up there, in order to conserve as much Estus as possible, you might want to take this guy out right here. So this is called a channeler. He's basically just a wizard. What he will do is he will buff all of the enemies around him with extra damage, which makes those basic hollows behind him actually hit pretty hard. They can nearly one-shot you. So if you have a bow, you can actually take him out from here really easy. Now, this crosshair is not really lined up in Dark Souls 1, so there you go. Aim slightly to the left of his head. And he doesn't like that. It hurts pretty bad, as you can see. But you can just sit here and whittle him away. And he hits pretty hard too, and it's kind of hard to get damage in on him with 10 hollows swarming you. So this is really, like, hands down the best way to handle this. He's got that trident in his hand that will do an insane amount of damage if he hits you with it. And he can also cast spells at range. So he's really just... pretty annoying enemy. There you go, he's dead. 1,000 souls, long live the king. I'm gonna go ahead and put this away. I guess a dead body falling got their attention down there. We're just gonna pretend like we don't know what just happened and head upstairs. So I don't really like to fight this guy on the stairs. It can be a little annoying with the height disadvantage that we have. Come on, man, you can do it. There we go. Easy parry, and apparently we caught this guy's attention from the other room, so not too big of a deal. Hopefully his friends don't join. Looks like we are alright. There you go, a Titanite shard, just like I said. Now the smart play would be to go upgrade this right now, but not really necessary. So again, there are lots of hollows. You can see like 2 to 3 maybe, but they are hidden all over. So slowly approach this door, get in the doorway, and then back out, and you can see all of them coming out of their hiding. So try to get them in like a single file line so they don't completely swarm you. Just take them out one at a time. Just keep backing up. You got all the time in the world, no need to rush things. And just take them out one at a time. The claymore has a really nice forward thrust. Apparently it's not as long range as I thought, but really good for these narrow corridors. They're all kind of getting stuck on each other because there's so many. But as you can see, There are tons of them. And if the channeler gets that damage buff off, these guys will absolutely annihilate you. Since they're so bunched up, it's really easy for them to hit multiple times at once. Two guys attacking you at one time. Absolutely disgusting how they're ragdolling at my feet. So yeah, be very careful. So the boss fight is actually up here ahead in this room. Before that though, I am going to show you where you can get one of the summons. Again, I don't like fighting on stairs, so we're going to pull him down here. Oh man, that didn't have very much range. Have mercy. Alright. So, moving on. Take one. What do you mean I died? I didn't die. You died. That green fog right there is nothing. So we got a plus two claymore now. Feels pretty good. Try and block that. Anyways, moving on up here. The only reason I'm showing you this, even though it doesn't necessarily pertain to killing the gargoyles directly, it is a summon that you can get, so I thought I would let you guys know. Having two summons for this fight is complete overkill, but you know. So we're going to go ahead and let him out. Again, completely optional. Talk to him, exhaust his dialogue, basically just keep talking to him until he starts repeating himself. At which point you can save and quit the game and he will disappear from here and go back to Firelink Shrine. If you talk to him there and then come back up here, you can get his summon sign. So let's just head on over to the boss. Now as we come up these ladders here, there will probably be quite a few summon signs from players just because this area is very popular. Actually not too many today, but Lautrec's sign should be down there somewhere, and the one that I definitely recommend getting that has pretty much no requirements whatsoever is Slayer right here. He will be the golden sign. You can just walk over them to see who they are. I don't know who this guy is, but shout out to him, I guess. And yeah, so I'm not going to take Slayer for this boss fight at first, just so I can show you the moves. Otherwise, like, the boss fight will end very, very quickly. Having a summon here is extremely effective. So, you actually have some time to get sorted here. If you want to buff your weapon with gold pine resin, now would be the time to do so. The gargoyles are very, very weak to lightning. But again, I'm not trying to kill them immediately. I want to show you guys some of their moves first. So, as soon as you go about one third of the way across this roof, you will trigger the cutscene. Alright, so here we go. First thing I want to mention, notice these very wide horizontal sweeps and the shape of this roof. So you really don't want him to fly, but what you can do is you can kind of use the roof to your advantage. If he's standing right up here on the ridge, it's very easy to just kind of like let those pass over your head right here if you go towards the lower section of the roof. But do be careful, you can fall off. See, he just completely whiffed that second one. So use that to your advantage. Another thing worth noting, he actually can drop pretty much everything that he's wearing. That stone shield that he's using, the halberd in his main hand, his helmet, and his tail actually as well. You see the axe on the end of it. So in Dark Souls 1, there's actually a mechanic where pretty much any boss with a tail, if you were to cut it off, you can get a weapon from it. Now, usually the weapon doesn't look exactly like the tail, like this one does, but still a pretty fun mechanic. They don't really have too much of that in the other Dark Souls games, but that is something to keep in mind here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Basically, just try to stay behind him, aim your attacks for the tail. and it actually does a lot of damage if you cut it off. So I'm kind of just toying around with him right now, trying to show off some of his moves. His flying ones are really the most dangerous. Pretty much everything else really easy to see coming, and again, you can kind of just miss it depending on where you're standing. And if you do want to get the tail cut off, try not to hit him anywhere else for a while. There you go. Because if you kill him before you cut the tail off, you won't be able to get it. Now, once we get this boss down to 50% health, another gargoyle is going to hop down from there and join us. He will start breathing fire. And once this boss gets down to 50% health as well, this one will also start breathing fire. So be very careful of that. If you haven't actually buffed your weapon with gold pine resin, once you get it down to about 50%, that would be a good time to do that, because you're going to want as much damage as possible to take out at least one of the gargoyles. Now, I'm going to go ahead and get him a bit lower. He's pretty slow between attacks. You can see it, leave him open quite a bit. It's actually just kind of in the nature of halberds. There you go, other one joining us now. You want to avoid that fire. That one actually spawns with 50% health, which is pretty nice. Now I'm going to go ahead and buff up here. Barely getting that off, but right here you will see. Also, while he's breathing fire, he is completely vulnerable to attack. He really can't do anything. I heal up while I have a chance here. And try to get in some damage. As you can see, doing a lot of damage with that lightning. And this one really does like his fire attacks, you can see. But now that he's doing it, completely vulnerable. And we can go and finish him nice and easy. And we were lucky enough to get the gargoyle helmet from that. So there you have it, gargoyles. You get some twin humanities from it. 10,000 souls. I did cut off the tail, which gave me the gargoyle tail axe. I'll show you that real quick. It takes 14 strength and 14 dexterity to wield. It is a pretty cool looking weapon, I think, but it's not the most functional. Kind of just fun to play around with. So your standard battle axe moveset, really. Pretty much identical to the battle axe, in fact. However, the heavy attacks are what makes it unique. It actually bends, seeing as it is a tail, which is pretty cool. Same thing with the one-hand attacks, it still bends, but kind of a fun weapon. If you do want to farm the gargoyle armor, or any of the gargoyle drops, you can't actually get the armor, but the helmet, the shield, and the halberd, you can kill the gargoyle, the first one, and then either die or homeward bone to get out of here. And if he didn't drop it, then you will want to come back and do it again. If you kill the second gargoyle, the boss fight will end, obviously. So just keep that in mind. There are a couple gargoyles later on in the game, so if you really do want them, you will have another opportunity later on. But that's going to do it for this guide. I hope you guys found something useful in this video. I hope I was able to showcase how to beat the gargoyles. I will put a clip right here of me fighting the gargoyles with a summon, and you can see just how easy that boss fight is. I actually record this video on another character and summoned Solaire for it, and the boss fight went too fast for me to even explain anything, so thought I'd just do it solo and then show you the summon version afterwards, which I'll probably do in all my videos moving forward. So with that one, guys, have a good one and good luck with the gargoyles.